I'd love for you to do.
These sixth graders from Willowside Middle School in Santa Rosa may be on the most productive field trip of their fledgling academic careers. Some are learning the basics of coding. Others are creating online designs that laser cutters and 3D printers will turn into real products.
I like the interactive part about it because I don't like just sitting at the desk and just doing my work. I like hands-on activities and always doing something.
Oh, it's so different, and it's cool to do the hands-on experience. We watch videos in class, and we do some hands-on, but like it's nothing like this.
This frenzy of activity and creativity isn't taking place at a school. The so-called design laboratory is actually located inside the Sonoma County Office of Education headquarters. It's the brainchild of Casey Shea, coordinator for Maker Education for the entire county school district. But what is making?
The shortest definition of making is taking an idea that you have in your head and holding it in your hands, going through the process to put it together, whatever that takes.
The maker movement, young people turning their creative visions into tangible and often practical or whimsical objects, is now a worldwide phenomenon with over 240 maker fairs across the globe. But it began right in Sonoma County with this man, Dale Doherty. The founder of Maker Media and publisher of Make Magazine wanted to promote the do-it-yourself mindset to help students learn STEAM concepts: science, technology, engineering, art, and math. A non-traditional approach to counter old teaching methods that often didn't resonate with some students.
I was a high school teacher for many years, so unfortunately by high school a lot of the kids, there's a significant number of kids who are sort of turned off to the whole system. And we're icing out a whole, you know, generation of kids or a whole group of students who could be the next innovators and the next, you know, problem solvers that we need.
I absolutely love coming to the design lab. It's one, the kids have told me it's one of their favorite trips of the year.
These students are learning about electricity as they create their own LED flashlights. Their teacher, Lisa Berges, says what she loves most about this lab and Maker Education is how it inspires kids who don't necessarily shine in a classroom setting.
It just allows freedom. It's discovery, and they go with their gut here, and they test, and they iterate, and they persevere.
Sonoma County School Superintendent Stephen Harrington became such an advocate of Maker Education that he and Shea started training other teachers in 2014. 1 year later, they joined with Sonoma State University to create the first fully accredited program in the nation, honored that same year by the White House. Now teachers come here from all over the U.S. to discover how to set up their own Make Labs.
There's a lot of things going for the Make movement because teachers realize that this creates an environment of creativity, but it also creates an environment of success for learning.
The design lab's even proven to be a hit among those in special education. Neal, who teaches visually impaired and blind students like Ricky, says they've worked together to create tactile objects with readable braille messages, like simulated calculators, computer keyboards, and other objects. Their designs are being shared around the world.
I send my files out and people download them all the time, and I see my things being used in all other places, and that's a pretty awesome feeling to see a kid in Canada using a thing that I designed.
It's very gratifying just knowing that other people are using designs that I thought of sometimes.
For Sonoma County schools that don't have the space or resources for their own maker labs, the county offers a mobile lab that comes to them. Over in Sacramento, UC Davis education professor Lee Martin takes his mobile lab out to schools all over the region. Like in Sonoma County, Lee wants to provide a space of possibility for students by filling his van with tools and materials to make stuff. Today at Sacramento's Met High School, Lee and these 9th through 12th graders are bringing power tools, a 3D printer, even a laser cutter into teacher Christopher Chu's chemistry class. They're all members of their own Makers Club.
One of the things that I love about the Maker stuff is that it's a place where learning new ideas, it's really clear how it's going to enable you to do new things.
It's really anyone who just enjoys inventing and kind of tinkering and just working with their hands to create something.
And one of the things I think that makes them really special, especially this group, is they like to take risks. They like to try new things and they're not afraid to make mistakes.
There's just this feeling of like success when you do something on your own, you make something and then you can look back at it in the future and say, I did that.
As an avid maker himself, Lee wondered if transporting a workshop on wheels to underserved communities would help spark curiosity and creativity in young people.
There are a lot of signals to young women and young people of color that say engineering, design are not spaces that are necessarily for you. And that's deeply problematic. By creating a space where they feel that they do fit in, by creating a space where they can be successful, it was something really tangible that they can walk out and say, I made this. I think that that at least has the potential to really show them that there are spaces in which they fit in, belong, and their ideas are valued.
Establishing maker programs and training teachers can be challenging, but most educators agree it can provide a spark that changes both students' and teachers' lives.
I'd recommend just trying it because it's really fun when you get to do it. And even if things don't work out, it's always a good experience.
Your students will benefit and you will love it because it's a whole new exploration of learning for you as an adult.
I would say just go for it. It's a little scary at first, but if you allow them flexibility and you trust them, they produce great results.